Hey, John, have you seen Sean?
He's out back.
Out back?
Yeah.
Hey, Sean! Yo, Sean!
Oh! Hey, Roy, how's it going? Oh, I'm just doing a little bridge repair on this guitar here. I'm Sean Staples. Hi, this is Sean Staples, and I'm here with the best tip that you can do with your guitar, Hero guitar. This is absolutely the best tip you can do. And get one of these and become a real musician. Practice your guitar, quit that phony stuff. All right, Sean Staples here, Cars Man out here in Hollywood, California. And we're bringing you another great story here. This one's about Pete Townshend. And I just wanted to share with you, I saw The Who in 1976 as a teenager, and the t-shirts were terrible. So I got this program instead. Boy, am I glad I did. You can see it's, tells all about The Who there, a little introduction, pictures of them. And it's really cool. There's Keith Moon. Yeah, see that each artist had all four members of the band had a two-page thing. There's Keith Moon's, and here's Pete Townshend's. So really cool. Just wanted to share this with you guys. We got a lot of great stuff coming up. Carr just works really hard on this channel, so subscribe so you don't miss a thing. Rock guitar pioneer Pete Townshend was born in a musical family in West London in 1945. His dad was a professional alto saxophonist and his mom was a singer. Pete traveled with his parents a lot until he was seven, so he got an early taste of the road. They didn't have a record player or radio at home, and only music Pete enjoyed until he was 11 was mouth organ. His grandmother, whom Peter later described as a clinically insane, bought him his first guitar for Christmas when Pete was 12 years old. So that was a really, really cheap Spanish guitar, Pete Townshend says. So Pete started exploring this instrument by breaking strings, and eventually when he got just the D, the G, and the B left, he figured out that he could play some chords on it. And he played for about 6 months on just those three strings and learned a lot of chords. The same year, Pete got a banjo and started playing in a small Dixieland band, the Confederates, with his school friend John Entwistle. He played banjo for about 2 years, and then he found a reasonably good Czechoslovakian acoustic guitar. Pete was an insecure kid who was frequently bullied at school because of his large nose. When Pete went to art school, there's a girl who was into jazz and talked about it all the time. So Pete started listening to jazz to keep up with her. Pete didn't like practicing guitar because his dad used to practice his clarinet in the back room all the time, so Pete decided not to do that. Around that time, Pete Townshend saw Ritchie Blackmore. This is what Pete recalls. I used to see Ritchie Blackmore carrying his guitar up and down my street when I was 14 or 15. Some jazz pianist down the road used to say to me, "You've got a guitar. There's a really great boy who comes and plays with me sometimes called Ritchie Blackmore." Pete also added, "Richie invented heavy metal. I didn't. He was doing it years before us and probably invented power chords as well. So I don't know why he's such a sullen, dark, evil mother," and he laughs. In fact, classical composers like Beethoven and Mozart used power chords. Old bluesmen would often use power chords, and the English rock sound The Kinks used power chords. It had been used forever, but Pete Townshend was the first one who coined the term power chord. Pete Townshend was also the first one who started using feedback on stage. Ritchie Blackmore cited The Who as a key influence for Deep Purple. In an interview, Ritchie Blackmore explained, "After listening to them in 1964, I realized that maybe I should have a go at writing because Pete Townshend's way of writing appealed to me. Luckily, it paid off in certain areas with Deep Purple." On why Deep Purple's song Smoke on the Water is so successful, Ritchie Blackmore explained, "Simplicity is the key. And it's simple. You can still hear people playing it at music stores. I never had the courage to write until I heard The Who song, I Can't Explain, in my generation. Those riffs were so straightforward that I thought, all right, if Pete Townshend can get away with that, then I can too." While Blackmore doesn't consider Pete Townshend a good guitarist, he recognizes that Pete was a pioneer to use guitar feedback and other cool things on stage. On who was the first to use feedback, Richie replies, Pete Townshend was definitely the first. But not being that good a guitarist, he used to just sort of crash chords and let the guitar feed back. He didn't get into twiddling with the dials on the amplifier until much later. He's overrated in England, but at the same time, you find a lot of people like Jeff Beck's and Hendrix getting credit for things he started. Townshend was the first to break his guitar, and he was the first to do a lot of things. He's very good at the chord scene, too, as well. Pete Townshend is actually well known for leaping stage acrobatics and, of course, destroying his guitars and amps on stage. Not to mention his windmill technique of chords playing. When Richie was asked why he doesn't leap around on stage, he explained, I like leaping around on stage as long as it's done with class, like Free. They're the best band in England. Paul Rodgers is a good singer and a brilliant mover. None of this jumping up in the air and doing the splits and all that. He just moves with the music. Not like Pete Townshend, who's gotten to the point where he waits until photographers are well aimed before he leaps. He's not very spontaneous. Townshend, in his turn, admits that he would never want to compete with virtuosos like Hendrix, Page, Beck, or Blackmore. He feels himself in a slightly different place because he gets the joy from expressing himself through a song, not through a guitar solo. Pete confesses that he did have a certain amount of jealousy towards those technical guitar players, but then he realized that it was worth trying to express himself through single note work. Townshend recently claimed that The Who invented heavy metal and they were copied by so many bands. On why today The Who doesn't sound like their earlier heavy metal anymore, Pete Townshend replies, at least I don't play mandolin like some rock stars.